Whenever oil prices surge, media publications run stories of how some company or inventor is building the car of the future that runs on water. These claims are generally misleading and are only trying to sell a dream: water as a fuel to revolutionize the automobile industry. The question is, do we really have the technology to use water as fuel to power our cars and other automobiles? Despite decades of claims of so-called water-fueled cars, why have none of them hit the consumer market? Let's start at the beginning. A water molecule is comprised of two hydrogen atoms and an oxygen atom, bonded by a covalent bond. The energy in water is chemically locked up in these strong atomic bonds. Now, water itself is not combustible. The only way to extract energy from water and use it as fuel is to separate water molecules into constituent elements. By splitting water, hydrogen and oxygen would be separated. Hydrogen gas is a combustible source of energy. Therefore, this hydrogen gas could then be used as a fuel, but not the water itself. Theoretically, there is a method to split water into constituent elements with the help of a chemical process called electrolysis. At the most basic level, electrolysis is a method by which water can be split into hydrogen and oxygen by passing an electric current through the solution. However, there is a small problem. Water is a poor conductor of electricity. One therefore needs to add electrolytes like lithium or sodium into the water to make electrolysis work. Electrolytes, due to their ionic structure, facilitate the flow of electrical energy through the water. Now, even if you add an electrolyte, there's another problem associated with splitting the water. As water is a pretty stable molecule, the energy required to split the molecule is more than the energy that would be derived by combusting hydrogen. Thus, extracting more chemical energy from water than the energy spent in the process of electrolysis is impossible. The basic rules of thermodynamics restrict us from creating any new energy from water without spending more energy in some other form. Scientifically speaking, it's not possible to make a fully water-fueled car without violating our well-established laws of thermodynamics, unless someone wants to expend more energy in order to derive less. Charlatans have made tall claims about developing water-fueled cars, but their claims were never verified or approved by authorities. While it's certainly enticing when a company or individual claims to have developed technology that can power cars purely on water, when it comes to science, there is a fundamental restriction to this very idea. Remember, energy can neither be created nor destroyed. Water cannot burn, so the only way to derive its usable energy is by splitting water into hydrogen and oxygen. As mentioned, the problem in doing so is that the amount of energy spent separating water into its constituent elements is greater than the energy you get back when they recombine inside the fuel cell. The laws of thermodynamics remain intact and cannot be bent, let alone broken. Thus, a truly water-powered car remains elusive and seemingly impossible. But who knows what the future holds?